How is male pattern hair loss diagnosed?
Male pattern hair loss is the most common cause for hair loss in men. The percentage of men affected by male pattern hair loss is also consistent with the percentages of men experiencing hair loss following what's commonly referred to as the rule of decades. For example, 20% of men in their 20s are developing pattern hair loss or experiencing it. 30% of men in their 30s, with the percentage of men being affected by hair loss increasing with age. At the same time, some men experiencing hair loss are often concerned about other possible causes for their hair loss, such as nutritional deficiencies, moving to another country, the municipal water they use, using hair color, amongst other possible explanations. I'll discuss how I diagnose male pattern hair loss in our office. I'm Dr. Amiya Prasad. I'm a diplomate of the American Board of Cosmetic Surgery and a fellowship-trained oculofacial, plastic, and reconstructive surgeon. I've performed surgical hair transplant throughout my career and have been in practice over 25 years. I'm also the founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, a system I developed for non-surgical treatment of male and female pattern hair loss after using a material called acellular matrix by acell and PRP for the purpose of improving outcomes of hair transplant surgery in 2011. Since that time, we've treated hundreds of people every year from around the world and have established a new category for the management of hair loss, particularly as an alternative to hair transplant surgery. It's important to distinguish hair thinning from hair shedding. For the purposes of this discussion, hair thinning is a decrease in hair density and thickness of individual hair strands consistent with genetic pattern hair loss, or androgenetic alopecia. Hair shedding is characterized by the individual being aware of a change in their volume of hair being visibly shed, oftentimes noticing a significant increase daily. People who experience this generally are concerned that if the process continues, they won't have any hair after the shedding continues at that particular rate. Just as hair thinning is generally consistent with the diagnosis of androgenetic alopecia, hair shedding is generally consistent with the diagnosis of telogen effluvium. Telogen effluvium is a temporary condition which occurs after a stressful event. Now, there are situations where hair thinning is also associated with hair shedding, such as in the case of genetic male pattern hair loss at an early age of onset, like around 17 to 18 years old, with a rapid rate of progression, so the individual is bald by age 22. Sometimes male pattern hair loss patients who are in their 30s to 50s will report that in the prior year, their hair loss appeared to accelerate. Generally, I find this to be a marker of progressive loss of the hair volume reserve that provided coverage, so any further hair loss appears to significantly reveal more scalp. It's well known that you normally shed about 50 to 100 hairs a day with little awareness, since hair is growing in and the scalp coverage remains relatively stable. When hair is thinning, the resting phase after shedding, known as the telogen phase, becomes prolonged, and the growing phase, or anagen phase, becomes shorter in duration. This typically is a slower and insidious process commonly seen in male pattern hair loss. In addition to lower density, male pattern hair loss is also characterized by miniaturization of the individual hair strands becoming progressively thinner. This is fairly diagnostic of androgenetic alopecia, which I will often show my patients with a microscopic scalp examination. So what can we do for male pattern hair loss after diagnosis? While male pattern hair loss can't be completely cured, we can help improve and maintain coverage within the constraints or limits of one's genetics. We routinely perform TrichoStem hair regeneration treatment, which can actually thicken thinning hair and stimulate regrowth of hair follicles that are dormant because of the prolonged resting stage or telogen phase. By improving hair thickness and the numbers of hairs, scalp coverage improvement can be quite significant. In contrast to conventionally offered PRP treatments, TrichoStem hair regeneration usually involves 1 to 2 treatment sessions with benefits lasting 3 to 5 years or even more. Depending on your hair loss classification, other medical options can be employed, such as the use of a DHT blocker like finasteride to address the DHT's effect on your hair. I hope this information provided you with a better understanding of male pattern hair loss. If you would like specific recommendations for your individual situation, you can contact us through our offices or websites for a consultation. Thank you.